Live from the Counselor Studios in Nassau, Bahamas, this is Bahamas at Sunrise. And now your hosts, Romuald Ferreira and Anastasia Palacios.
Good morning, Bahamas. Welcome to Bahamas at Sunrise. I'm Romy Ferreira.
And I'm Anastasia Palacios.
And it's a fabulous Friday show. But before I go any further, I want to say a very special anniversary to Erica Mancio.
All right. All the best to you, Erica, and to all of our viewers out there listening. I had the opportunity to run into some of you this week, and you say how much you enjoy the show and you enjoy watching Romy. So I appreciate that so much, and we hope that you are blessed to have a wonderful weekend.
You don't have to hope. Only good things happen to you when you watch Bahamas at Sunrise. And as usual, we're so pleased that you make us a part of your morning. And I forgot to mention that Erica is celebrating 10 years of marriage, so she must have done something right over the years.
Nothing wrong with that. That's awesome.
But it's got an exciting show lined up for you this morning. As you may or may not be aware, it's Deaf Awareness Week. And so on Bahamas at Sunrise, we try to make you more aware of the issues that affect our wider community. And this is certainly one of them. So you want to stay tuned for the segment in relation to that.
So we'll be celebrating Deaf Awareness Week, but there will also be Women's Entrepreneurship Day next week. Looking forward to having a conversation on that and finding out how women entrepreneurs are impacting the world.
You know, you may or may not know it, but women lead the way in entrepreneurship in the Bahamas as well. Mm-hmm. Also, we're going to discuss the grouper close season. This is, in fact, very important for maintaining this very important fishery. So you want to stay tuned, get all the information about how you can be compliant, and actually you can be a part of the solution to our grouper stocks, and I think that's very important.
I think so too. So for all my boil fish eating people, that segment is going to be for you. We're going to bring that to you and much more, but first let's take a look at weather with Godfrey Burnside.
Weather at Sunrise, brought to you by Bahamas First. First in insurance, today, tomorrow.
Thank you, Star. Good morning, Bahamas. Your first look at weather sunrise. In your first surface chart, we have a stationary front across the northwest Bahamas that will dissipate during the daytime hours. High pressure will build, and then we do have a second front that will move into the Bahamas, northwest Bahamas, by Saturday, and that's going to cause some showers, possible thunderstorms, but some windy conditions into early next week. In your satellite, you can see very little clouds this time, but the streaming clouds across the northern Florida area that's moving towards the southeast. Any weather day, we're looking at probably sunny and warm. The chance of a few brief showers. High temperature reaching 89 degrees Fahrenheit. Tonight, we're looking at a few and mild clouds around the island. Still a chance of a few showers. Your low temperature going down to 75 degrees Fahrenheit. And some region highs and lows across the Caribbean, Barbados 86 and 78. In Jamaica, 88 and 76. Trinidad, 89 and 75. And the Turks and Caicos Islands, 87 and 78. Across North America, Atlanta, 57 and 35. In Raleigh, 62 and 38. In Miami, 85 and 74. Dallas, Texas, 66 and 47. And Toronto, Canada, 46 and 32. And we'll find a weather look. We expect increasing cloudiness through the weekend with some showers and possible thunderstorms. Also, some windy conditions. So we're asking small craft to stay in the airport over the next several days as those winds pick up sometime late Saturday into Sunday across the Bahamas. That puts a wrap on your first look at weather sunrise. I'm Godfrey Burnside. Back to you, Romy.
Thanks, Godfrey. Let me give you a statistic. There are approximately 70 million people who are profoundly deaf in this world, and the Bahamas is no different. We have a community or a segment of our population that is in the same shoes, so to speak, and here to talk about it and bring awareness to those that live with this particular challenge. We welcome from the principal of the Center for the Deaf in the person of Sonia Roll. She's joined by Sandra Sweeting, who's the vice principal of the Center for the Deaf, and of course, Dr. Deborah Newbirth, who's an audiologist. Welcome to Bahamas at Sunrise.
Thank you.
And I believe as we do this interview, we're going to have it in sign as well by Kayla Rohr. So we got the full perfection going on inside here. Ladies, it's a pleasure, though, to have you here. So let's talk a little bit about the challenges then that face the deaf community and, of course, how that translates into the goals of the Center for the Deaf, because I know the Center for the Deaf has goals, and those goals are a response, really, to the challenges and the needs of the community.
Let me begin first, then, and speak to the goals.
Sure.
At the Center for the Deaf. It has always been our lifelong ambition to make our children functional at the end of their school time with us.
Yes.
And so we have always had programs that catered to both our academic group and to the group that is on a vocational track.
Okay.
And so we have seen over the years, and I'm new in the chair as principal, we have seen many of our students able to function in the community.
Oh, that's really good.
As, full-fledged citizens. Some we were able to take back on at the school and become craft instructors, some who has walked into their giftings, and because their gifts made room for them, they became seamstress, they became other things like that. And that has always been the steps that I have followed. But what I would like to see more of, because I'm seeing a challenge today with so many of our children, because we perhaps have not done enough vocational training for those who are not on academic track. We need to see them become more apprenticed to other people, such as plumbers, electricians, and so when they're finished with school, they can walk into a career. And so that is our goal in our, you know, we are planning to build a new school very soon.
Excellent.
Yes, because very soon I believe the University of the Bahamas is going to ask us to leave their premises where we are because they have one room for expansion.
Sure.
So in our new school area, we are looking to see more of that kind of program instituted in our schools where some of our older students who are really not doing much in the community right now, they can come back in the evenings and they can be properly trained to be functional in our society.
Now, when people think of the Center for the Deaf, you hinted at a lot of stuff right then and there. You don't think, are you offering then a full curriculum school and education?
We do.
Yeah.
We actually, our children write national exams, those that can. As I told you earlier, we have two tracks.
Sure, sure. I mean, that's no different from the broader community.
Right. And so we have two students that attended H.O. Nash, but they were deaf students that went there with a teacher.
Excellent.
And they both passed 5 BJCs.
Excellent.
Yeah.
So that tells me then that the goals are there and you're achieving some of the goals.
We are.
But of course, we don't live in a perfect world.
We are.
And so
that leads to some of the challenges that we are having.
Yeah, sure.
You know, we prepare the students and they do well, and we have some who went off to college and came back. Mm-hmm. And at COB and BTVI right now, these students cannot go to classes because there's no one there to interpret for them. There's no note takers, and there's no assistance at the school, at these institutions to help these students.
That's very interesting. I'm thinking out loud now. Is there some kind of computer program or app that can translate words into sign?
There is technology for that, but right now that's not being used at COB.
Ah.
And we are hoping that our COB evolve into the University of the Bahamas, that we can see this kind of program coming on stream.
Because you want to include everybody.
All inclusive is the word.
Well, actually, the state our country is in, when we say all hands on deck, we mean
all hands.
So we can't really exclude anybody.
Nobody should be excluded.
We need the contributions of everybody.
We need the contributions of everybody.
That's interesting. And I remember, like, some time ago, many, many years ago, I think I must have been in grade 5, there was a lady came by with a machine, and she said, they're going to test your hearing. And everybody was like, well, what is this all about? But I guess this is something that Dr. Newbirth does every day. And so let's talk a little bit about the importance then of, I would imagine, early detection is what we're really talking
early
about.
Early detection. Currently in the Bahamas, we don't have a plan in place for infants to be tested, but we are working toward that goal. There's something that we're working on currently. But as far as testing is concerned, every person should at some point have a hearing test, because a hearing test is going to alert you to other diseases that you may have in the early stages. For example, kidney diseases, high blood pressure, diabetes. These people are prime candidates to have hearing tests, because we find too with these diseases there is a decline in the hearing. People who have hearing loss, they may feel, well, only a deaf person has a hearing loss. But with children, even a very mild hearing loss can cause problems with educational deficits, language and speech delays, socialization problems, behavior problems. So we may have kids in the school, they've never had the hearing tested. It's not something a person can see. The teacher doesn't realize it, the parent doesn't realize it, but the child has a hearing loss that is so mild that they're not functioning at the level that they should be able to. As far as adults are concerned, an untreated hearing loss can lead to things like depression, anxiety, mm-hmm. isolation.
I'm sure, because you can't hear the basic mode of communication. How much help then is there in terms of technology, implants for those who suffer from these kinds of challenges?
Currently, we have all the technology we need here in the Bahamas. Mm-hmm. For those who are able, there are hearing aids available. I work out of Comprehensive Family Medical Clinic across from COB in the Wilmack building. They can have hearing tests done there. They can have hearing aids prescribed. We have just newly introduced cochlear implants into the Bahamas, but there's only certain segments of the population that would qualify for that particular procedure.
All right. Well, ladies, thank you so much for taking time out and being on Bahamas at Sunrise. I have to warn you, though, only good things are going to happen now that you've been on Bahamas at Sunrise.
I know.
And if you shake this good luck hand, it's going to travel. But congratulations
for the wonderful work that you do.
And we're certainly very proud of you and all of your accomplishments. Come back and see us anytime. We were talking with Sonia Rose, Sandra Sweeting, and Dr. Deborah Newbirth from the Center for the Deaf. You're watching Bahamas at Sunrise. We'll be back after this.
Good afternoon. First response, how can I help you?
I've been in an accident on West Bay Street. Can you send someone to help?
Yes, ma'am. A first response team will be there in 15 minutes. Are you hurt?
No, I'm fine, but a bit upset.
We're glad you're not hurt. Please, try to relax. Our team will take care of everything as soon as they arrive.
First Response provides immediate on-site service and support from the scene of an accident through the claims and repair process. And it's free to all Bahamas First insured drivers in New Providence every day for any type of accident. If you drive and want First Response on your side, call 32FIRST or visit BahamasFirst.com for the name of an authorized Bahamas First agent. First Response can't prevent an accident from happening,
but it can certainly ease your mind when it happens.
The Department of Statistics will carry out its annual labor force survey during the period of November. Enumerators with official identification cards from the department will visit selected households in New Providence, Grand Bahama, and Abaco, and will be calling upon residents to complete the questionnaires honestly and accurately. The information obtained will be handled in the strictest confidence and will be used to maintain essential statistical data on our country.
Need a business license? Simply apply and pay online with the user-friendly online tax administration system, OTAS. VAT registrations, payments, information, forms, confirmation of applications or payments, all online. Even the business license will be emailed directly to successful applicants. So why waste time? With OTAS, our doors are always open. Access OTAS, the online tax administration system, at vat.revenue.gov.bs or email us at taxinquiries@bahamas.gov.bs or call 242-225-7280.
Welcome back to Bahamas at Sunrise on a fabulous Friday. Women have been starting businesses at a higher rate than men for the last 20 years and tend to create home-based micro and small businesses. women will create over half of the 9.72 million new small businesses expected to be created by 2018 in the United States. Here to speak with us about women and business across the Caribbean is our own Simone Bowe. Simone, good morning and welcome to Bahamas at Sunrise.
Good morning. Thank you.
Now, Simone, you are here to share with us about two fantastic opportunities for women in the Bahamas. And I want to get right into it by finding out first, what is the Women's Innovators Network Caribbean?
That is a part of the World Bank Group, okay. The InfoDev, and it is sponsoring through funding from the Government of Canada and the World Bank, a peer mentorship program for high potential women entrepreneurs.
Awesome.
So typically you would see programs out there for people who want to start a business. Mm-hmm. This program is unique because it is for women who are already in business,
okay.
And they want to upscale their business.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it sounds very good, but how exactly does that acceleration program work? You talk about moving it into something new and something bigger. How does it work?
Well, it is an 8-month intensive program.
Okay.
So it's just not a one-day workshop or just a one-off thing because the creators have recognized that people, entrepreneurs especially, need support.
Yes.
So not just information and access to information, funding, technical skills, and all that sort of thing, but you need support. And so it's an 8-month intensive training program that incorporates a number of modalities of ways that the information comes across. So there is peer mentorship.
Okay.
There's one-on-one coaching that will meet the individual needs of that entrepreneur and mentoring with a local entrepreneur who is already, you know, fast-tracked already.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Exactly. And technical workshops. Mm-hmm. Personal development sessions.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a wide range of delivery options that should really be able to boost that woman entrepreneur so that it's not just information and then you're left on your own to flounder
this
and wonder
really
how
good.
To figure it out.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So I'm excited about this. And I know that I have some women out there listening. They want to know, okay, how can I take my jewelry business from what I have now into something major? They're doing something. How do you get involved in the program? When can you apply? Where can you apply? When is the deadline?
Well, the application process is actually open now.
Okay.
And it ends November 27th, and it is an online application.
Mm-hmm.
So if they were to go on the Women Innovators in the Caribbean, it's called WINC for short, Acceleration Program.
Mm-hmm.
There's a Facebook page. There you can go on the InfoDev website, and you can contact me. I'm the local accredited facilitator, and they can apply online. That's the first step. And after their application is processed to see if they meet the criteria for the program, then there will be an interview process after that deadline is completed. So the interview will take place in December, and the program will roll out early 2016.
All right, that's awesome. So Simone, just give us your numbers just in case somebody wants to reach out to you. What's the best way for them to do that?
Sure, they can call me at 458-8938, or they can email me. My name is Simone with two M's, S-I-M-M-O-N-E, at makestrategictransitions.com.
Okay, and so that's the WINC, W-I-N-C program. I really want you to look this up. Find out how you can be involved because this sounds amazing. Now, Simone, in addition to this, you are also organizing the Women's Entrepreneurship Day. See, you are a woman.
I know, right?
So what is happening with the Women's Entrepreneurship Day? What is that?
Well, this is a part of being in the right place at the right time.
Okay.
And so as a part of going to be accredited for the WINC Acceleration Program, I met all of the other facilitators from the 12 other Caribbean countries.
Okay.
One of whom is the regional ambassador for Women's Entrepreneurship Day.
Okay.
Which is a movement that began last year by Wendy Diamond and endorsed by the United Nations.
Awesome.
And so as a result, she asked us, you know, submit your application to be a local ambassador. And so I was accepted as the country ambassador. Thank you. And so it's exciting. So on November 19th, worldwide is Women's Entrepreneurship Day.
Okay.
And it is a movement to celebrate, to support and empower women entrepreneurs
Speaking
and causes.
Okay.
Yes.
So what events will be happening on the 19th?
So on the 19th, we will have a Women's Entrepreneurs Symposium and Expo at Malia that starts at 5:30. And we're really excited about this very first time that we're doing this. We think that it's going to be very inspirational mm-hmm. and informative for our women entrepreneurs. Mm-hmm. We're going to focus not only on information that we think they should have, we're going to have coaches there, we're going to have CEOs there who are going to talk about their experiences of being in business.
Wow.
We're going to have innovators there mm-hmm. and in video, mm-hmm. people in new media, people in STEM, you know, okay. science, technology, engineering, and mathematics.
Uh-huh.
It's just a wide range. Also, we have partnered with Junior Achievement, mm-hmm. as you are aware.
I am.
Junior Achievement sponsored, along with Citibank,
uh-huh.
sponsored a young woman's entrepreneurship competition.
Mm-hmm.
And the five finalists will be pitching their business idea wow. live to a panel of judges
okay.
at that event.
Okay.
And on December 2nd uh-huh. will be our social media campaign for WED.
Okay.
So we hashtag Women Wow,
uh-huh.
and we're going to be having a meet, greet, and tweet mixer for entrepreneurs
right.
at Safadilla Estate.
Listen, this sounds like this is going to be some exciting stuff happening for women entrepreneurship. Mm-hmm. I want to just find out one more time how people can reach you, because I know they want to know about all these events. This is just a brief synopsis of what's about to go down, and I don't want them to miss out.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. My number is 458-8938. Call, text, WhatsApp.
458-8938. You heard it here first, our ambassador for women entrepreneurs in the Bahamas, the one and only Simone Bill. Thank you for joining us on Bahamas at Sunrise.
Thank you so
much. Looking forward to an excellent week and for many events to come.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
You're watching Bahamas at Sunrise, where the reason that we have this show is because of a woman entrepreneur, and we'll be right back.
The beauty of Bimini is seen all around.
The beauty of Bimini turns people into friends.
And friends into family.
It's soothing.
It's healing.
The beauty of Bimini keeps our guests coming back.
It's in the faces of our people.
It's the people.
The people.
The beauty of Bimini is people to people.
Mr. Turner is in a rush for a chance he doesn't want to miss. With over 14 destinations to choose from, you can see why he's so eager to experience the world-class staff and service. Sky Bahamas, flying into more cities in the Bahamas than any other airline in the world. When it comes to the skies of the Bahamas, we simply do them better.
When I fly with Sky!
Sky Bahamas!
Welcome back to Bahamas at Sunrise. It's now time to talk grouper and how we could protect the grouper fisheries stocks. And this is certainly a very important conversation. And so we're joined by two very lovely ladies from BREEF, Bahamas Reef Environment and Educational Foundation, in the persons of Kasherina Lambert McKinney and Chantal Curtis. Ladies, welcome to Bahamas at Sunrise.
Thank you.
It's good to have you here. Let's talk a little bit then about the closed season, because in a lot of ways we're balancing long-term fisheries protection against short-term gain. Of course, it's an intricate balance, but it is something that we would describe as necessary, would we not?
Absolutely. So this legislated closed season has been a long time coming. People have been learning more and more about the importance of protecting our resources so that we have them for the future. And so now we have a closed season between December 1st and February 28th. Every year going forward, there will be no confusion about this going forward.
Why is it important? Well, why this particular time, though? Why was this time selected?
Well, the reason why this time is important is we recognize that the grouper is spawning during the months of November to March. So this is an opportunity for them to be able to reproduce. They only reproduce once a year, pretty much during a specific season. So unlike other species, which might be continuously reproducing year round, there's only a set season that they reproduce. So we give this species and a time to reproduce, and so that we can have fish for the future.
All right, now, so what you're really protecting then is the spawning aggregations of these particular of this particular species.
Absolutely. So groupers are called groupers because they group together. They form these aggregations or schools, and they'll sometimes swim over 100 miles to get to one particular place where they reproduce. And this makes them vulnerable to fishing. It makes it really good fishing at that time, if you want to catch a lot of fish quickly. But it has led to the complete collapse of Nassau grouper in countries all around the region where they used to be abundant. So we have a chance in the Bahamas to protect them by protecting these spawning periods and these spawning sites to make sure that we do have them for fishermen to enjoy for many generations to come.
Let's talk then a little bit about how the mechanisms behind enforcement of this particular directive.
So this falls under the jurisdiction of the Department of Marine Resources. It's a change to the Fisheries Jurisdiction and Conservation Regulations. And it prohibits the sale, the capture, the landing, the offering for sale of Nassau grouper, any Nassau grouper, during this 3-month period. So the rest of the year, you're good to go. You just have to have them at least 3 pounds in weight. But during this 3-month period, you're not allowed to buy them, sell them, offer them for sale. And this doesn't just refer to fresh Nassau grouper, but it does refer to other species and makes a provision that other species of grouper have to be landed, brought to shore with the head on and the tail on and the skin on. So you can determine that if you go out and you catch a rockfish or you catch a black grouper or something, it's not a Nassau grouper.
Well, that's interesting stuff. So at the end of the day, the idea is to protect these spawning aggregations so that as we move forward into the future, we can have lots more. Any recommendations as to what people then should go out and get for their boilfish for Christmas? If it's not going to be Nassau grouper, then what can they have?
Okay, well, we love to tell people go out there and eat lionfish. Lionfish is actually an invasive species here in our waters. Mm-hmm. Lionfish, they eat any and everything that they can get pretty much their mouths on. So they are a species that threatens other reef species. So we encourage people to go out there and eat lionfish. They are venomous, not poisonous. So once you remove their spines, they are very good to eat. They are meaty fish and they're very tasty. I would think that they taste a lot better than Nassau grouper, so that's my opinion, but I encourage you to go out there and try it for yourself. And then, because it's a closed season just for the Nassau grouper, there are still other types of groupers that you can collect during this time. Then there's also snappers and other reef species.
All right, so there are alternatives.
There are alternatives.
Or you can go vegan then.
Nassau grouper is only one fish species out there of the tons of fish species that we have out there. So it's just one that we're trying to protect at this time.
So people will have a chance to try lionfish if they haven't tried it at our brief fundraising event on the 28th of November. We do one every 2 years, so it's going to be a special event. People can find out more by going to the brief website to get information about that event and also to get all sorts of educational resources about grouper and other species. So this is a resource booklet that we've put together for teachers and students now that Nassau grouper and other marine species are included in the science curricula at many different age levels. So you can go to the brief website, download these great resources, and make sure that your kids do well on their exams, because there may well be questions, particularly this coming year, since we've had a change in the legislation about Nassau grouper in school exams.
It's interesting stuff. I wonder if the change in the legislation can be justified by diminishment in fisheries landings in relation to Nassau grouper.
So I think your question is referring to, you know, have we waited too long?
I was just thinking out loud in terms of when we passed the legislation to close the season, was that based on the fact that the Department of Marine Resources noticed a decrease in landings of Nassau grouper, or was that based, did we wait to see that, or did we act before that happened?
There's definitely been a lot of research looking at specific spawning aggregation sites and the number of fish that are taking part in this reproductive activity. And there has been a dramatic decline in that.
Okay.
From the range of 100,000 fish at a spawning aggregation site to about 20 or 30 at
wow.
that same location. So a really dramatic decline. And that's, you know, in a specific time and a specific place.
I would describe that as decimation.
I would say that's more than decimation. So that, we have very, very clear evidence that we have seen a
sure.
dramatic decline. There's also quite a bit of fisheries independent research going on, where basically you swim along a reef and you count how many Nassau groupers you see, and you compare that with what that may have been in the past or what that may be inside a marine protected area, for example.
Okay.
So we see a big difference there. Sure. Fisheries landing data is showing a bit of a decline, but that is subject to so many different other variables. Sure. You know, how many people are out fishing, how well the numbers are being gathered, because it's hard to get that information. But, you know, this decision for the legislation is based on very strong science. And it's certainly a very positive thing for Bahamian fishers and the public.
Well, Chantal, since this is my first time interviewing you, I'll give you the last word. Remind our viewers of the closed season.
The closed season for the Nassau Grouper is December 1st through February 28th.
All right. Well, ladies, thank you so much for joining us on Bahamas at Sunrise. Keep up the work that you're doing.
Okay.
Excellent stuff, and hope to speak with you sometime in the future.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
You're watching Bahamas at Sunrise. We'll be back after this.
Great news! The Department of Inland Revenue is offering new real property tax benefits in the form of rate reductions and a general discount. On owner-occupied properties valued at or over $75,000, the rate has been reduced from 0.75% to 0.625%. Properties valued at under $75,000 will be subject to a levy of $300 yearly. More good news! The tax rate for commercial properties valued up to $500,000 is down from 1% to 0.75%. There's more! Pensioners who are Bahamian citizens or permanent residents are eligible for a 50% reduction on owner-occupied properties valued under $1 million. Best yet, a 10% discount on property tax will be available on all accounts that are current and paid in full before March 31st of each year. To learn more, call the Department of Inland Revenue at 242-225-7280 or email us at taxinquiries@bahamas.gov.bs or visit the Real Property Tax Operations at the Department of Inland Revenue in the shops at Carmichael Plaza, Carmichael and Palmetto Roads.
There's no place like Exuma.
With our striking, beautiful waters.
And loyalist tombs.
And even warmer hearts.
And there are no people like the people of Exuma.
We are the people.
We are the people.
We are the people of People to People, Exuma.
Volunteer as a People to People ambassador today.
And now, your hosts, Romuald Ferreira and Anastasia Palacios.
Welcome back to Bahamas at Sunrise. What a fantastic show we've had so far. I want to give out a brief reminder that this is Deaf Awareness Week. It starts this week, and it starts on Sunday, actually, and there will be free hearing screenings at the Comprehensive Family Medical Clinic from 10 to 2 on Friday, November 20th. The price is free. It's from 10 to 2 on Friday, November 20th at the Ponciana Drive location near in the Wilmack building. So okay. I want everybody to take advantage of that. I think that's very important.
That's a great opportunity. I had the opportunity to get my hearing and vision tested when I was in primary school. And so it's really good when you can know in advance what you're working with, and then you can help your children to navigate based on what you find out. So take advantage of that opportunity. We've still got so much more to come, and I'm really excited to share with you. We'll be talking more about all of the things happening in Deaf Awareness Week, and so you want to stay tuned for that.
And we'll hear from the credit union. I always want to find out about, well, it's Christmas season.
Yeah, up, man.
So getting those finances in order, very important. Excellent stuff.
And in addition to that, we also have National Children's Week next week.
Wow.
And so we'll be finding out some more about what's happening with our children. Yeah. You want to stay tuned for that segment as well.
Excellent stuff. Speaking of children, I want to say a very special happy anniversary to Erica, who had three of them for me. 10 years. 10 years and counting, but no more children. So enjoy your anniversary. But before we get to any of that, I'm going to give a second and final look at weather with the Dapper Don himself, Godfrey Burnside.
Weather at Sunrise, brought to you by Bahamas First, first in insurance, today, tomorrow.
Thank you, Romy, and good morning, Bahamas. In your second look at weather, Sunrise, the tropics, with 17 more days left in the 2015 tropical cyclone season, the tropics remain quiet and a tropical storm formation expected during the next 5 days. on the local scene. That satellite shows that very little clouds of the islands, a beautiful day in store, weather-wise across the islands. But the second cool front is to move into the islands late tomorrow afternoon, and that will cause some increasing cloudiness, showers, and thunderstorms. Also, some windy conditions through the first part of next week. In your marine forecast today, those winds northeasterly east at 10 to 15 knots, sea 2 to 4 feet over northwest and central Bahamas, easterly at 15 knots, sea 3 to 5 feet over the southeastern islands. On Saturday, those winds continue northeast to east, but increasing 15 to 20 knots, sea 4 to 6 feet. But by afternoon, those winds will be up to 15 to 25 knots, seas building 5 to 8 feet, some windy conditions. And then on Sunday, those winds northeasterly at 20 to 25 knots, seas 6 to 9 feet. So we have an advisory posted to your boaters to stay in port or near port over the next several days. And northeast to east at 15 to 20 knots, 4 to 6 feet over the southeastern islands. Yeah, tides. You can expect a low tide at 8:27 this morning. Next high tide will be at 2:54 this afternoon. Low again tonight at 8:44. Sunset at 5:23 this evening, rises tomorrow at 6:26, UV index 8, your water temperature 79 degrees Fahrenheit, and your moon phase, no moon. External look, increasing cloudiness, showers and thunderstorms, and windy conditions starting late tomorrow afternoon into probably Tuesday, whereas next week, so the beginning of the week could be a wet and windy one, though 70 daytime will be in the mid to upper 80s, at nighttime in the lower 70s. That puts a wrap on your final look at weather sunrise. I'm Godfrey Burnside, back to you, Star.
Thanks, Godfrey. National Deaf Awareness Week is only a week in a year where we see highly concentrated advocacy to raise awareness about the deaf community at the individual, community, and governmental level. This week strives to promote the rights to deaf people and to spread the message as widely as possible while encouraging deaf people to learn to communicate. I'm joined this morning by Kayla Rohr. She's a missionary from the ICCD and a sign language interpreter, Tali DePoma. She's also a missionary from the ICCD. We welcome them this morning, and with us signing for you right now is Ms. Deborah Wright from the Grace Community Church Deaf Ministry. Ladies, welcome to Bahamas at Sunrise.
Thank you.
So I want to start by finding out, when exactly is National Deaf Awareness Week?
Deaf Awareness Week is being kicked off this Saturday with a fun walk, mm-hmm. and so it's the 14th through the 22nd of November.
14th to the 22nd of November. And what is this year's theme? I see you wearing these beautiful shirts. Does this have something to do with it?
Yes, our theme is Born for a Purpose.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And so it's a reminder, I guess, to people everywhere that no matter what challenges you face, you're still born with a purpose. I'm born the way you are with a purpose, right?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Now, what are some of the events that will be taking place as a result of Deaf Awareness Week?
Well, we're very excited to actually have a partnership with the Bahamas Deaf Awareness Week. Mm-hmm. We will have different variety of churches along with the Center for the Deaf to pretty much work together to bring the deaf awareness in the Bahamas. Mm-hmm. We'll also be sharing the gospel with the deaf in sign language as well. We're also wanting to do is have our two deaf evangelists coming from the state.
Okay.
And they'll be pretty much with us a whole week. Uh-huh. And they'll be sharing the sermons in sign language. We also want to do is our goal is to bring everybody together, deaf and hearing, to celebrate the deaf culture in sign language.
All right. So you are from the ICCD, which I know is the International Christian Centers for the Deaf. That's correct?
Yes, ma'am.
And so what are some of the goals of the ICCD that brought you here to the Bahamas?
Yes, our mission is to reach the deaf for Christ,
okay.
specifically making sure that deaf people around the world have access to sign language, education, and the gospel.
Okay.
And so we decided to partner with Abundant Life Bible Church mm-hmm. in reaching the deaf community here in Nassau by establishing a deaf ministry within their church,
okay.
as well as a outreach program to the Family Islands. We had noticed that there was a need for the deaf to receive the gospel message in mm-hmm. their own heart language of sign language, as well as on the Family Islands, we realized that there was lack of access to education and even sign language for deaf in the Family Islands.
Yeah.
So it's our goal to make sure that deaf people have access to sign language, education, and the gospel of Jesus Christ.
All right. I mean, those sound like pretty good goals to me.
Yes, ma'am.
So
yes, ma'am.
I know that I've done some research on you, and I know that you've been to Abaco before to help raise awareness there. How long have you been coming to the Bahamas?
We've been here since September of 2014, so we just celebrated our year of service, and we've traveled to Abaco, Eleuthera, Freeport, and Long Island.
Okay.
Again, our goal being is searching for the deaf community and seeing how we can assist what the needs are and trying to develop a program that will meet those needs.
All right. Do you plan on traveling to any other islands?
We would like to. Okay. Again, our time is a little bit limited here. Okay. We have a 2-year commitment, mm-hmm. but we'll see how God leads with that. Maybe mm-hmm. he'll bring us back for a longer term because we would love to see more of the beautiful Bahama Islands.
All right. And how can people reach out to you? Because there might be people listening to the show right now who might know of some communities that have not been reached yet. How can they reach out to you for more areas of partnership and ministry?
Well, what we're going to do is, this is the reason why we went to the Deaf Bahamas Awareness Week, is we're actually doing a kickoff tomorrow at the Center for the Deaf. We're having a fun walk.
Okay.
At 6 o'clock a.m. in the morning, mm-hmm. we're going to bring deaf and hearing to come.
Mm-hmm.
And pretty much what we're going to do is have t-shirts and on sale for $15 and students for $10. So adults for $15 and $10 for students.
Mm-hmm.
Include that you have a chicken salad and a booklet.
Okay.
So all can come together and do a fun walk. We're also going to have a kickoff service at Abundant Life Bible Church
mm-hmm.
with Pastor Cranston Knowles. He'll be sharing his sermon in sign language
from
10 to 1 p.m. So mm-hmm. we're very excited to see that. I know he's excited for that
uh-huh.
as well. And then we'll also have individual nights. We're going to have Monday through Friday, November 16th through the 20th.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have First Baptist Bible
mm-hmm.
Sharing the theme, which is Born for Purpose.
Mm-hmm.
And then also have Tuesday, we have the Deaf Culture Night.
Mm-hmm.
We'll be teaching basically the Deaf history and the language.
Okay.
Wednesday we have Deaf Social Night
mm-hmm.
where we'll be pretty much having a together with deaf, meaning hearing, and we have a pizza night, and just also we're going to be doing sharing the gospel.
Okay.
And then Thursday we're having a Center for the Deaf where they'll be doing a talent show.
Oh, that's so
and
cool!
And so we have individual deaf students performing science songs and dancing, as well we have different deaf adults
uh-huh.
doing the exact same thing too.
Uh-huh.
And all those nights Tuesdays and Wednesday and Thursday is uh-huh. at Abundant Life.
Okay.
And then Friday, which is at Grace Community,
mm-hmm.
they'll be doing a game night.
Okay.
So all those events will happen at 7 o'clock p.m. through 9 p.m.
Okay.
And sorry, yes.
Well, is it open to anyone?
Like, yes, it's open
okay.
to hearing and deaf,
okay.
and it's for free.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty much, we just want to have them come and see what we want to do.
Mm-hmm.
But also, we're having this really cool event called the Silent Carnival.
Okay.
And the Silent Carnival is at the Abundant Life Bible Church
uh-huh.
from 1 to 4 p.m. We want to have the community come and join a carnival atmosphere
uh-huh.
where we want to do the twist. We won't have no one talking.
Wow.
You can, if you know signs, you could use that.
Uh-huh.
Or if you want to be ready to communicate, just write back and forth.
Okay.
But we have people who is playing cops.
Okay.
And so they hear you talking, they take you to jail. So that's going to be really, really exciting to see about how it goes.
Uh-huh.
We did it last year. It went really well. So we're going to make it bigger for this year.
Okay.
And then the last event we're going to do is Sunday, November 22nd, at the Abundant Life Bible Church from 10 to 1 p.m. We're having our deaf evangelist from the state, Ronnie Rice.
Uh-huh.
He's going to come and actually share his sermon in sign language.
Okay.
We'll also have different varieties of churches as
uh-huh.
well to pretty much do the whole sign of song and scripture readings and sign language.
That's awesome.
So we're just very excited for that. And if we have, you know, more information, if they want to contact us,
mm-hmm.
our number from Abundant Life Bible Church office
mm-hmm.
is 8134.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can reach Center for the Deaf, which is the number is 323-6767.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can even check us on Facebook.
Okay.
We're definitely there always. And so the most important thing we want to do is bring deaf and hearing all together to experience Bahamas Deaf Awareness Week.
All right. So. Ladies, listen, this is exciting stuff.
Yes.
And I know for people who are in the deaf community, it's just so exciting to be able to do things that are normal and to have fun and to play games.
Yes.
And I think it's really important for people that hear as well to do a silent carnival
mm-hmm.
so we can know what it feels like to not be able to talk.
Yes
ma'am.
And I hope you get
yeah.
a lot of people in jail.
Oh, yeah. Well, Silent Carnival is free admission with games and prizes, but food and drinks are on sale.
Okay, so free admission. That's going to be not this Saturday, but the following Saturday mm-hmm. coming. You can find out more information by going to Abundant Life Church or by even checking out the Center for the Deaf. Thank you so much for being with us, ladies. Yes.
Thank you very
and
much.
For the work that you're doing in the Bahamas.
Thank yes. you.
We'll
Thank
be right back after this.
International comedian Maja Hype, also featuring Miam Simpson, aka The Baddest Thing Joking, hosted by Sawyer Boy. Friday, November 13th, Super Club Breezes Ballroom. Happy hour doors open at 6 p.m., showtime at 8 p.m. sharp. Mission Possible Ace Diabetes Health and Wellness Expo. Saturday, November 14th, New Providence Community Center, Blake Road, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. There'll be free health screenings, free dental checks, free eye screenings, games and fun activities, prize and giveaways, and much more. Sundance Beach Party, featuring music by DJ Bravo. Saturday, November 14th, Nirvana Beach, 12 noon to 6 p.m. Life at Key International School will host an admissions open house 2015. Saturday, November 14th, Life at Key International School campus, 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. All parents are welcome to attend to learn more about our curriculum, programs, and incredible college entrance statistics. Burns House Group of Companies presents Junkaloo FanFest 2015, featuring Roots. Saturday, November 14th, Butland Science Grounds, JFK Drive, gates open at 5 p.m. Bahamas AIDS Foundation 22nd Annual Red Ribbon Ball, under the theme, A Night of Luxury, featuring entertainment by the Defense Force Pop Band, Tingham Dem Orchestra, and music by DJ Killer B. Saturday, November 14th, Grand Ballroom Atlantis, cocktails at 7 p.m. Flair 242 presents Unfaithful, music by The Mighty Pencil, alongside Playhouse DJs and DJ Overdose. Saturday, November 14th, Super Club Breezes, 10 p.m. until. Better Living presents 17th Annual Health Extravaganza. Sunday, November 14th, Christie Park, Nassau Street, 1 to 5 p.m. There will be free cholesterol and glucose testing and tasting of healthy cholesterol-free dishes and more. King Dawn National Parkinson Foundation 5th Annual Speech Competition. Sunday, November 15th, National Center for the Performing Arts, 3 p.m. Book launch, The Colorful History of the Bahamas, a souvenir guide for visitors by Alan Murray. Sunday, November 15th, Dungalek Studio Art Gallery, 3 p.m. to 5 p.m. That's your weekend calendar. To have your event posted on the calendar, please don't hesitate to email us at calendar@bahamasandsunrise.com.
No place like Exuma.
With our striking, beautiful waters.
And loyalist tombs.
And even warmer hearts.
And there are no people like the people of Exuma.
We are the people.
We are the people.
We are the people of People to People, Exuma.
Volunteer as a People to People ambassador today.
Are you behind on your real property tax? The Department of Inland Revenue is offering shelter. From now until December 2015, the DIR is extending a waiver of the property tax surcharge to registered owners of residential properties in one of two ways. One, set up a standing order or salary deduction arrangement to pay your property tax arrears and the current tax. Or two, pay your outstanding tax bill in full. To learn more, call the Department of Inland Revenue at 242-225-7280 or email us at taxinquiries@bahamas.gov.bs.
The Bahamas Island Cooperative Credit Union, also known as BICU, recently held a health fun run walk. This initiative was an effort to assist in the hurricane relief for the Southern Islands. CEO of BICU, Mark Bastian.
This one is kind of unique in that we actually wanted to make sure that we do something for the victims of the recent hurricanes down in the Southern Islands of the Bahamas. So we partnered with the Head Knowles Foundation. The full proceeds of this event will go towards the hurricane donation, partnering again with the Head Knowles Foundation.
Bastian also said that the motto of BICU is people helping people and that they will do their best to help people who are in need.
We're still going to continue selling the t-shirts that we would have gotten in order to raise the kind of monies that we expect. But we'll also make further donations on behalf of the members of the credit union to those victims.
Amongst the participants was Tall Pines MP Leslie Miller, who expressed his gratitude for this event.
It's a wonderful thing. You know, Bahamians need to come out and exercise and live a good, healthy life. I love it. And I want to thank all the sponsors and those who put it together. I look forward to it every year. God spare my life.
Dr. Nello Corbell was the oldest participant and winner in his category.
Well, I think it's something that is very commendable to the group that set it up and the people who participated. I think they should be given second thought. You know, it's real taxing. It is not an easy race. And the older we become, is the more we feel it.
Winning the over 40 male and female walk category were Margot Strawn and David Strawn.
This morning the race was quite challenging because I had to do the two bridges, but these events are so fun and so rewarding and so healthy for each individual who can try to come out and participate in this event, in any event, in fact. because now you see the Bahamas is trying to get much more healthier and they need to try and participate in more activities.
Exercise on the whole is the thing of the day. You know, it's a health thing. It'll keep you fit. Also, as you get older, it helps you with your health.
Head Notes Representative Brock North shared the progress of the Hurricane Relief Project and how persons can contribute.
Head Notes was just founded by two of the most amazing women I know, Gina Knowles and Leah Head, came about just as Bahamians wanting to help each other out. And it became such an amazing drive that it's just touched by none. And we're actually now in rebuilding stage where we're asking the public for building supplies. If you can donate shingles, nails, paint, whatever you can for our brothers and sisters in the South who really need it.
This is Travis Edgecombe for Bahamas at Sunrise.
National Children's Week has been observed since 1995, and it seeks to capture the attention of adults in order to inspire them anew to be positive with their children by offering them the very best they can give in every area of their life. Sounds good, doesn't it? This morning, we interview Ken and Harry Ward, Miss Zenobia Pierre, and our 4A's band, Anya Russell, Aaliyah Johnson, Abria Johnson, and Emil Johnson. They're all here to tell us about National Children's Week. Welcome to Bahamas at Sunrise.
Thank you.
All right, you guys sound like you're still sleeping, man. All right, now welcome to Bahamas at Sunrise, Father Ward, Canon Ward, sorry. We got to talk to you. We got to find out how this all came about and what you actually hope to achieve by bringing focus to our nation's young people.
Well, it all started in 95, as we just heard. And it was all because I felt the need to seek out solutions to the many problems which were being aired on our various radio stations at the time. Everybody was coming forward with problem after problem, and my thing was, well, what's the solution? And it came very strongly to me as an educator that if we're going to bring about the kind of transformation the nation needs, then we need to deal with the children.
Of course.
The young minds. And so if we're going to deal with young minds, of course we have got to treat them as celebrities, celebrate them, because then we get their attention.
Yeah, sure.
And we raise the self-esteem, and of course, the nation takes off.
Hey, the nation will benefit from it. So what are some of the highlights then for this week?
We are at St. John's College to open the week on Sunday at 4 p.m. with a concert, and then of course, there are some of us who will be at Sunderland's Primary School for their assembly on Monday morning. Some will be at the Simpson Penn and William A. Pratt grouping to work with them. There's a young man who was at the Simpson Penn School and is now on the Defense Force, and he's going to tell a story.
Awesome.
And it's going to be really terrific. We ask various schools to do their own thing, since we don't have this straight-jacketed type situation. We call on all the schools and all communities to really put their creativities to work. And so during the week, we suggest, of course, certain things that happen. And then, of course, on Saturday at 5 p.m., we are at Rawson Square for the grand finale of the week. Now, apart from all of this, there are persons who are celebrating in Family Islands. We have chapters of the BNCC, that is Bahamas National Children's Commission, in Grand Bahama, in Bimini, in Exuma, and of course there's one that's coming back to life in Eleuthera, and of course in Long Island.
Okay.
So we are seeking to just spread this movement throughout the Bahamas, because it's really not a movement of Nassau.
Excellent.
And at some point, we expect it to go beyond the Bahamas. So, what's the idea? It is that we get the attention of adults, not just parents, but particularly parents, adults everywhere, to take note that our children need us if they are going to make the difference about which we're going to be proud in the future. They are the young nation now, and we certainly don't want to lose them.
All right.
So we celebrate them, show that we love them, we appreciate, we recognize, They are special, they are precious, they are ours.
Wow.
Indeed. And we're speaking of ours, we have these, the four A's band. I think everybody's excited to hear what they have to offer. They say they sound real good.
Yes, they say.
They name themselves.
I see Sonobi is there. Whenever Novi is there, I know something is happening good with music. So Novi, you're helping these young people to get prepared.
Well, these are my students.
Okay.
I teach at the Aubrey Sale Primary School, and they're my students. Abria is at H.O. Nash, but she just graduated in June of this year.
Okay.
And so she's still, you know, a student of mine.
Uh-huh.
And we are doing the theme song that Father Ward has written.
Okay.
And they're just going to give a little a cappella, you know, their little take on it this morning.
All right. Well, I see a junk new drum, so I'm ready.
Well, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, we're so very pleased to present at the beginning of National Children's Week, the 4A's Band.
And it's free, gift from God for you and me, to be used with liberty, even as a little baby. Children are gifts from above, given by the God of love. We were once like them alive, as the bees of the beehive. Celebrate, 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 celebrate our children. Need us, need us now. We must find our way somehow to meet every need of theirs in their precious childhood years. Children must be learning how to live on their own somehow, learning how to rise and cope in the little of faith and hope. Celebrate, 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 celebrate our children.
When you need to fix up your garden, you need Fox Hill Nursery. Orchid supplies, in and outdoor plants, terracotta pots, landscaping plants, fertilizers, soil mixes, gardening tools, they've got it at Fox Hill Nursery. When you need to adorn your garden with beautiful plants and flowers, you guessed it, Fox Hill Nursery, Bernard Road. Call 324-1302 or 324-6147. Remember, at Fox Hill Nursery, we take care of your whole garden.
The Department of Statistics will carry out its annual labor force survey during the period of November. Enumerators with official identification cards from the department will visit selected households in New Providence, Grand Bahama, and Abaco, and will be calling upon residents to complete the questionnaires honestly and accurately. The information obtained will be handled in the strictest confidence and will be used to maintain essential statistical data on our country.
That's going to do it for us. Thank you so much for tuning in. As you see, National Children's Week next week, Deaf Awareness Week next week. Our thoughts and prayers are, of course, with the family from QC at this time. And we're just wishing the country all the best. See you Monday.